Alright, today JB gonna make that blackened fish. The fish that I got that I can get real easy. Is catfish. So I got some catfish fillets. The very center part of the fish, they take the head section and the tail section out, and it's the best part of the catfish. Bought them up at Sam's. They flash frozen, and they fresh right over here from my neighboring state, Mississippi, which is like the catfish capital of the United States. They got more catfish farms over there. They farm raise them, and it's real good, healthy fish. They taste really good. Freshwater catfish is good too, but I ain't got none. Anyway, this recipe comes from the Louisiana Seafood Cookbook. Recipe from Louisiana Sea Grant Center for Wetland Resources, Louisiana State University, Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Look like this program is maintained by the National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Administration, U.S. Department of Commerce, and the state of Louisiana. Copyright date is 1986. We got a bunch of good seafood recipes in here. Today I'm going to make a recipe for blackened redfish with this, and you see this page is real, got a lot of stains on it. We use this a lot. But this same recipe, you can make blackened steak, blackened chicken, or blackened fish, whatever you want. So what I got down here, over here, boy, I got some salt, and I'm going to give you all the proportions. Some onion powder, garlic powder, black and white pepper cracked up, sweet paprika, red pepper, oregano, and thyme. And I'm going to mix all this together, and we're going to coat them fish down with that. And look here. And to make this, what you do after you got them in that, you get a cast iron skillet. You got to use cast iron, and you don't want to do it in your house. You take this outside. This outside cooking. And it's raining right now. I'll go under the carport if I got to. But you get that skillet. If it's nighttime, that skillet gonna have an orange glow in the bottom of it. That's how hot you get that skillet. And you take that catfish right before you put it on, and put a little squeeze of lemon on it. Put a tablespoon of butter and stand back, because it's going to catch on fire. That butter's going to light up. Put that catfish in there, or that fish in there, or chicken, or whatever you're doing, and let it blacken on one side, and it's going to release itself. And you flip it over. Well, before you flip it, you skeet another little bit of lemon juice in there, and then another little teaspoon of butter, flip it over, and let it cook on the other side. If you're doing chicken now, and it's kind of thick chicken, you know, boneless, skinless fillets, what I would do is finish the chicken in the oven after you done blackened them out there, because you know how chicken is, you got to get it above a certain temperature internal. Where fish cook like that, chicken take a little longer. Just a little word. So I'm going to mix all this together. I'm also making, I found this over at Target. Being as this is a French dish, I figured I'd get a French-inspired entree. Herbs de Provence is some kind of pasta. I'm also going to make a salad with my daughter, BM Chevy Girl's recipe for feta garlic salad dressing, homemade. You talk about got some kick. It ain't nothing like no Greek-Lebanese recipe that you ever had in one of them restaurants. This stuff, it's bad news, and it's thick enough where you can dip it on a cracker and eat it. And boy, it's good. It like, whoa, it lights you up. There's lots of garlic in it. Let me show you how to make that. Hey there. How y'all all again today? I'm glad for y'all to be here and paying attention, boy. I'm going to lower the camera a little bit, so y'all can see what I'm doing. Alright, let me check you. Yeah, you look okay. Alright, I done chop up two big toes of garlic. I mean big ones. They were big, big fat, almost big as my thumb in there. That's for that redfish. Here's my mortar and pistol right there. And what I'm gonna do is I need to make a paste with the garlic and some salt. We're gonna put a little salt in there, and I'm gonna start mashing that around, and I'm gonna make a paste with that. And then I'm gonna put it all, this is my motorboat, the top for it. It also got a little blender on the bottom, and we're gonna put it in there with some feta cheese, and we're gonna put in some olive oil, and that olive oil is gonna make like a mayonnaise. You know how you make mayonnaise, don't you? If not, I have to show you another time. Anyway, I'm gonna make a paste with all that garlic, not the whole piece, what I already chop up, and put that in there, and we're gonna go. I'm gonna show y'all. Watch, pay attention. Pay attention, boy.